Hello everyone, welcome to Match Review, Masandown Fan Vlog. Mamelodi Sundowns against Marumo Gallants.
Yeah.
Match day two of the league, ne? Match day two of the league. 6 points.
Yes.
So important.
Yes. So important.
Just annoyed by the goal we conceded.
Wait, ruined it, but
that goal.
And after the penalty save, I think you're not really more.
Yeah, I think it. I wonder if they had scored the penalty. Yeah, I was gonna take it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Otherwise, you good?
No, I'm good. I'm happy. 3 points. Played well. Saw lots of goals. Nice.
Also, it's good when your entire front three scores.
Yes.
Your starting front three scores.
Mm-hmm.
It's always a good sign.
And they look like they have an understanding. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's nice. It's nice.
You know, I can't fault Coach Dendens because how he started is exactly what I love about him. He's one coach that is brave to play.
So brave. We were speaking about it before tomorrow. Highlander Dendens, not many coaches would come here
and play that high line.
Yeah.
And also, like, you play that high line against the Reyners, against Tashrik, against Tapelo. Like, that speed is just...
Yeah.
It's almost... It's bordering on suicide to play high line when you're up against those type of players. Example, like Lucas.
Yeah.
I mean...
Yeah.
But what a good performance.
Very good performance.
Good, solid performance. Solid performance. You know, it's day and night. When you think of... how we played in the MTN 8 to how we've been playing lately.
Yeah.
And you encouraged.
You are.
You encouraged. The doubt that was created by the performance here at MTN 8 is slowly fading away when you see Sundowns not just win, but perform well.
Very good performances.
Looked
like our old selves. Solid.
That's my thing, Linda. Like, the more we look like ourselves, the more the concerns
fade
away. You know. Yeah. And this team is still gonna beat a lot of teams. They're still gonna beat a lot of teams.
Yeah. I'm just hoping. Well, obviously, Armo. Not even gear three, we're building up slowly ahead of steam. Maybe get two nyana, and we're still giving. We are already giving teams force. So
yeah. And also, the real tests are gonna come when we start playing group stages. No matter how bad Chiefs can be,
yeah.
Playing Chiefs at FNB as well is not an easy thing.
It's not.
Especially like Chiefs playing a big game, Coffin B. Chiefs can play against Golden Arrows, Coffin B, and lose 4.
Yeah.
Easy.
Come a big game, Coffin B.
They're a different team.
Yeah.
They're a different team. So that's why I still regard it as a test.
Mm-hmm.
Or it's our first test for the season.
It is.
Actually, it's our second test because I can say Stellenbosch was the first test because Stellenbosch, because of how we've played against them in the past and how they've done so far in the PSL.
Yeah.
I think they were a stand test and it's a test that we failed.
Mm-hmm.
Our second big test is coming up on the weekend, but let's not dwell on that too much. Kajeno, we are back to our lineups being unpredictable.
Yeah.
For some 11 reason, changes.
For some reason. 11 changes.
11 today. Changes.
I that's it. I expected that lineup.
Nah.
I can't say I expected that lineup.
Nah, I can say obviously expected Ronwen. The back four for me is expected now. Grant Libusa, Tiwani, and Tapelo. And then midfield, River, Allende. Those are expected ones. But like, yeah, Aubrey, you are like, because Mabue was playing, you know?
Yeah,
it's just there. The front three, Kion and Elenguchencha. Tashrik, maybe sometimes Shaulile.
Yeah.
Yeah. But
hopefully in the future Temba's one in. Hopefully.
I'm Agiz boy. Agiz, I don't wanna lie.
Yeah.
He might start on Saturday. But
you think so?
I doubt it. Yeah, but like it's a big game, boy. Sometimes, as much as like a coach really confident in whatever, but like what Dybala boy or Temba in your starting lineup just makes things way easier than
for you. Yeah.
Than where you are when you start. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. But to be fair, lineup region, you have to say it was solid. It's because solid. Of I mean, anytime your front three scores, ah boy, you have to.
and that midfield, you find it difficult to go anywhere in the PSL to find a better midfield.
But still, like any midfield that doesn't have Tebow Mokoena, boy, Tebow Mokoena is the best midfield in the country. Boy.
True. But imagine the midfield there, we have River, Alinde, Opremudi. There's a lot of football there.
Too much football.
There's a lot of football.
And I think also that's one of my concerns because with the Alende is a player that will always want to make things happen. Aubry has to make things happen.
Uh-huh.
River. Like the thing is that you have to budget ka a player like River, Mohung, like needing a player tonally. A player like Tebza who has like the athleticism. The physical attributes, Tebuho, like you need those
to
things.
Compliment River, more Alekhanya, right?
But yeah, also, right. Like, control and also the unpredictability. Like, in that midfield, no one shoots from outside the box. Only Tebza does.
Only Tebza does.
Lebza, when he's there, at least he's one who will take a shot. Aubry will take shots here and there, but
not as frequently as Tebza.
And also, like, when Tebza has the ball in certain parts of the midfield, like in the zone 14. He gives trust to the defenders, which opens up. Like, it's just a lot of
wonder.
Yeah, but all in all, because for me, this is almost like the chameleon approach that Rolando spoke about. Or sometimes, you have, but it's horses for courses.
Yeah,
you have to, because it's a team like Marumo Gallants, you can afford to play the baller fella.
Yeah.
Because you know who, like, they're not that strong.
They're true. True.
Yeah, they're
true.
Not that strong.
True.
But the lineup region for me,
I liked it.
I
like the lineup. I like the performances. Obviously, the goals. Good start. Goes and downs for Reyners.
Very good start, boy.
Very good start.
Very good start. This is his second league goal, ne?
Yeah.
And the three goals.
Two.
And then three goals all in all because he scored in the Champions League. Very good start for Inas, boy. Very good start. Especially because we are in a moment where Shaluli is really struggling.
Struggling for goals.
Yeah.
I like his performance. I like he looks solid. He looks ready and fit to help us.
But this is a profile that we've been needing for so long. Because even 2 seasons ago, we were using Tapelo in that space. This is a profile we've always needed. That's when I really wanted us to go for Fagri Lake. Or him, actually.
Because
you need that profile. Because he's a very. You can look at the speed. Look at Fakri is Bergman. Reyners is a good finisher. Good finisher boy.
No go expect someone at a touch, then I first time finish. Oh,
and you must look at all his finishes, boy. Like solid.
Yeah, solid.
Solid stuff.
Solid.
Yeah. I was now to be honest, I the only thing I can say I fault in this game is the how we failed to manage to control the game towards the end. We gave a lot of chances to Marumo Gallants towards the end, even how they also got their goal.
As much as our subs made a difference, our previous league game, didn't know they made a difference, but this time it dipped.
Yeah.
When we made the three subs, our performances dipped.
I think the one glitch, the one dent, is playing Mali in the six. I think playing Mali in the six, Kion and Turka were dealing because for a boy who just came from the, even in the DDC, he played, there's games where he played in midfield, but he's been playing centre back so much. And then now when he comes to Sundowns, like this is the PSL, boy.
Yeah.
Like the pace and the intensity of PSL is not the same. To put him in the six, like that, playing in midfield in the PSL requires a bit of experience.
Yeah, it does.
Or if it's not experience, it must be your natural position. I think that's the one thing. I feel like Kion Antoine Zingor will lose the control.
Yeah.
Kion Antoine Zingor will lose the control because we put him in that river role and, I mean...
True. Unfair on him.
Yeah.
Unfair on him.
He's a special boy, but
to this performance.
For your PSL debut to be in midfield.
Yeah.
When you performed so well in the Champions League, go centre back and even got a goal.
Yeah. I wonder what was the reasoning behind Humeago 6.
I think it's almost similar to, because even on Saturday, when he brought in Johannes, Keegan Johannes, he played him in the six. But we were playing, I mean, it's a team from Swaziland. With all due respect, you know what I mean? But I think, except for that, I think everything was brilliant today.
Everything was brilliant. Everything was good.
Yeah.
Top performance.
You want to go into the ratings?
Eight and a half for Ronald.
But he made a lot of good saves.
He did, especially in the second half.
He made a lot of good saves.
Marumo Gallant he had a few shots here and there after the Damona Tsweni, Gabadinho Tsweni.
He's a menace.
So Ronza for the penalty save, eight and a half.
Tapelo, I think it's an 8.
An 8, yeah.
Tapelo was good.
Oh, brilliant, especially for staff.
Tapelo was very good. Brilliant. Like, the way he found space behind the defense here, Marumo Gallant, he had a free passage.
Like you said, it's suicide playing Helene against Tapelo. Suicide.
Yeah, against this team, already, key suicide. But now, like, you have to deal with Tapelo. Reynas, Teshrik.
Lucas coming in the space, creating.
It's suicide, boy. I thought Grant was solid today. Grant is those type of players that sometimes in the game, maybe like Moon, you don't even see him.
Yeah.
You don't even see him that much, but another solid performance. I mean, he's the defender of the season for a reason.
Mm-hmm.
It's not by fluke, mm-hmm. It's not by chance. And also, he could be a two-time defender of the season if you think about it.
Bafana's number one center back.
But listen, go Hugo Bruce. At AFCON, yes, definitely. But lately, he was very solid.
Very solid.
Libuza, did he retire from international football?
I don't think so. Why is he not picked? And he's been on
are we the only ones who's in the performance day?
National coach, I won.
I think I'll give Libuza. Grand move, you know, guy?
I think number 8.
8.
8.
Yeah. Libuza 8 as well.
8.
Yeah.
Solid.
Diwane?
7.5.
7.5. I think so. I think he's had better performances than today.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's had better performances than today. River, another player. Kana, whose code is that? Yeah, how do you look at so and so.
And you don't.
You look at the game, you don't see so and so. And then you look at so and so, you see the whole game. That's River, boy.
Yeah.
That's River. River, play him in any system.
The control. The 8.5. 8.5.
I'm not sure about Marcelo's rating. Maybe you can help me out.
Had two very good opportunities to score.
Mm.
One got first half where I shoot him over
the bar.
Over the bar.
Yeah.
The other one, I think,
the rebound.
Yes. And the other one, the keeper saved. So, all busy performance. Played the full 90 minutes, which I didn't expect.
Yeah. I think same rating as Diwane.
Yes. Yes.
Nice.
7.5, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
I think Aubry as well, 7.5.
Yeah.
But I think Aubry was way better in the second half. I think in the second half, Aubry was much, much better. Especially... when he comes in and he becomes our first receiver, he makes life easy for us.
He does.
And he was attacking the spaces so well. But Marumo le bona at one point, I don't know if maybe like it's too many fringe players who haven't played much football in the past season or two. But some of the spaces they were opening up was amateurish. It was amateurish. And if you do that against a player as good as Aubry is, he's gonna poke holes.
Yeah, in your defense.
In your defense. And I think he poked holes in the midfield. There's moments where Edgar Managa, like, no one or Mobile Bile has given up, if we're being honest.
But Maposa, with the ball.
Yeah, Maposa, there's too much football there.
Yeah.
Too much football. And Ali Tembazwane, they changed our game against SuperSport. And today, he was very solid.
Started
very, very, very solid. Yeah. But I'll still give him a 7.5. What rating do you have for Lucas Ribeiro?
A nine. Oh.
Yeah,
Is he currently the best player in the league?
I think so.
Yeah.
Between him and Saleng right now.
Yeah. But there's something Lucas Ribeiro, man.
He's looking very good, boy.
He's looking so good.
But I also think the way we're playing now, it suits him. Because he's in the hole.
And he has speed around him.
Yeah. Also, like, his low center of gravity, the way he knows how to beat a player. And also, like, he sniffs out these, like, pockets.
Uh-huh. That's how we give more talk.
Yeah, in the last line of the opposition, like, he... Like, look at how he scored his second goal. It looked so easy. Sometimes it looks too easy for him.
Too easy for him.
Yeah, it looks too easy for him. I think you gave him the right rating.
What a footballer.
Yeah. Tashrik, 10.
10, yes.
10 out of 10.
This is the Tash Rimbonega preseason.
This is the Tash we saw preseason. But also the Tash we saw against Chiefs last season.
Yes.
This is the Tash we saw.
Aggressive, running hard.
Yeah.
First baller to Reyners for our second goal. Yo.
Actually, boy, Lucas Ribeiro. I think let's make it a 10.
A 10 for Lucas.
The moment Ginahanaka Tashrik, I think about how every time Tashrik looked good, it was centered around Ribeiro. Okay. Look at his Tashrik has two assists and a goal. Kajen. The assist aggregating to Reyners. Look at that ball from Lucas Ribeiro. you know what I mean?
Oh.
I think Boyanali Lucas Ribeiro Kajen is a 10.
Yeah.
I think 9 Ramrob.
So
Lucas Ribeiro.
Reyners Kikela 9.
Yes, I think Reyners is the 9.
Yeah.
Tash and Lucas Ribeiro 10, boy.
10.
I think Tash was good today.
Yes.
His goal might have been scrappy, but for him to even think about finishing it with his left foot, with his weaker foot, you miss half of the shots you don't take. I forgot the saying, but like it's basically saying like, if you don't shoot, you don't make them.
Yeah, true.
You know what I mean?
True.
So Tesh Kajenu, like as much as that shot looked tame, but he made it.
Yeah,
he he scored.
He made it.
Yeah, but also like I think I commend him more for the two assists, the first one to Reyners and the second one to Ribeiro. That was very good.
Yeah.
That was very good play. And also, because we've been crying for Temba's one, like if Temba is not playing, at least let's see let's have a creative spark.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yes.
Yeah, let's have a creative spark. Okay, you can make a case here, Horishikasa Dala, because this is what these guys are doing.
But Tesh put up his hand today.
Yeah,
he put up his hand.
The only thing I wish Ka Tesh Lemang. Yeah, I think him, like, it's just consistency. Because Tesh, you want more on a boy, Hore. He has a finish on him.
Yeah.
He's a very good player. All he needs is consistent. Like, and the thing about Tesh is that when he doesn't score or assist, there's not much to say about the performance.
But when he does, like today,
he lights up the stadium. You know what I mean? So I think what I need from him is the intangibles, Hore. Even when you don't score, or Blevela Peter, like, Peter is not scoring, but he's a menace.
He helps the team somehow. Yeah.
I think that's what I need from Tesh. When you don't score, when you don't assist, show. I'm not saying he doesn't show it or he hasn't. He has, but like at least like the consistency. Can it come in a much better volume?
I agree.
Yeah. Spelelo was good off the bench.
Scored again.
in back-to-back games. Have he ever scored back-to-back games for Sundowns?
I wonder.
I don't think so.
I wonder.
I don't think so. But all in all, I was happy with performance. High.
Yes.
I think performance as Pelelo was very good off the bench.
Yeah.
I think
he might have been our best player off the bench.
You know, definitely.
Definitely
our best player off the bench. Otsenile Lizuko Lipita, ne?
Yeah. Not so great, got both. Zuko probably.
Zuko didn't have a good performance off the bench.
Probably get the worst game morning.
Zuko play.
Yeah.
And he's usually like very solid.
Yeah. Considering the penalty.
Yeah. And like needlessly so. Even coach said it was a stupid penalty to concede.
Yeah.
Blesser 8. Peter Do you have a rating for Peter?
Six.
Zugo 5?
Yeah.
Zugo 5?
Yeah.
Lodge look good as well.
It look good.
What's on the Lodge, Lima? No, man. Zugo has another Lodge. Zugo's another Lodge, boy. Oh, okay. Rebetse Malibongwe.
Oh,
Malibongwe is the one who came on. Yes, yes. Do you have a rating for Malibongwe?
I don't actually.
I think it's a 5.
5.
And it's unfortunate because Kasatartaha, he was.
Limufile was good. 10.
You gave him a 10?
Yeah. Yeah.
At least I'm glad.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, the academy graduates, yeah. It's not easy to give them anything less than 6, yeah. But in some games. And I think also, but I think it's not his fault, but like he had a lot of misplaced passes when he came on.
More position.
Yeah, I think the position was something maybe that just threw him off. But it's not like he had a stinker. He didn't have a stinker. He had an okay performance. But in that position, you have to connect passes, the weight of your passes to be solid. Like, there's just too many things. Like, there's a lot of moving pieces when you play in midfield, because you have to deal with, you have to manage the game with your center backs, but you also have to connect with the attacking players. And there's a few balls to Zuko. But you know, I'll give him a 6, boy. You know why?
Uh-huh.
I was happy to see him breaking the lines. I was happy to see him
attempting
to go into the spaces, the open spaces.
Yeah.
I think I'll give him a 6 for that. I think that's a decent performance, yeah. Off the bench. Lodge. Lodge Lizugo, but then around the 70th minute, ne?
Yeah.
Yeah, but I don't really know.
Nah.
Didn't see him. I didn't see much of him.
Same.
I didn't see much of him.
Same.
I don't have a rating for him.
For Lodge.
Yeah, I don't.
Yeah. Interesting word that I'll go with him is Saturday. You know Lodge.
He loves the stadium.
He's that opponent, yeah.
And he played well last season,
he
eh?
Did.
Played
he
well
did.
Last season. The coach, a 10 out of 10.
I'm going to go a 9 because one quit here because of the subs. The drop lanes in intensity.
Standard.
Standard starting. So I was going to say 9.
Okay, I'll take your 9.
Yeah.
But it's a valid reason.
Yeah.
It's a valid reason. Supporters, I'll give them a 10 as well.
10.
Yeah. You can never fault Sundown supporters for many things. Sometimes, obviously, we come here and there's, I think it's because we're too involved, like we're always in the mix, in the thick of things. So sometimes when you're looking from afar, like from where I was sitting, I was able to observe. Is about that
yeah,
because I think I was outside of it, so I wasn't involved in. I was just not happy about Pelala Temba Zone. Why?
They did go. After the three subs,
yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, coming here on a Tuesday, guys, like, you need to go with something.
Yeah.
You need to go with something, guys. On Saturday we're going to FNB, guys. Let's be early.
Let's be early. Let's be loud.
Let's be early, guys.
Let's be early.
Hutomaga neo kena rfang butata. Uma sandansungo ote neo kena rfang butata more than anyone, guys. Please, let's be early on Saturday. Arutuhenga 12.
Yeah.
It's fair day, yo.
Yeah.
Ah, it's fair day. Yeah. Arutuhenga 12, and then get the gana go. You know. No, Rasa Rasha, Rasa Tangi.
Yes.
No, Yaguar, no, for 3 of one.
And
come back home, and then we can, you know, we can record an international break after issuing hands go FNB. But yeah, all in all, guys, it was a good game today. There's not much to complain about. If we are complaining about something, it's something we're nitpicking at. But today,
very good.
Yeah, this team is starting to look good. No one takes the league after, but my ball has arrived, and I agree. It's looking good, and I'm so confident that we're gonna go there and
win.
Definitely, we'll win, boy, we'll win. Otherwise, we'll see you on Saturday, guys. Have a good week.
Thank you.
Sharp.